Today's the day, 17th of September, 2024. In a few minutes, an asteroid the size of a cricket stadium is about to approach Earth. So the asteroid is called 2024 ON.
NASA has issued an alert for a stadium-sized asteroid set to make a close approach to Earth on Tuesday. The 2024 ON asteroid measures 290 meters across.
I don't see it.
Well, that is because this asteroid isn't really close enough to be visible by the naked eye, let alone impact the Earth. The thing is, we are bad at detecting asteroid impacts in time. In fact, here's a graph of all the asteroid impacts that we have predicted over the years, and here's a graph of all the asteroid impacts that we missed. We are objectively not very good at this. So in this video, we are going to figure out how this asteroid trajectory is predicted in the first place. Clearly see trajectory, the movement of this asteroid. We are going to discuss why it is so bloody difficult, can barely see them through our telescopes. And we are going to look at an asteroid about which, if we are wrong, can result in an impact nearly equivalent to 66,000 Hiroshima bombs. Let's figure it out then. So let's talk about how we find an asteroid in the first place. Most of the asteroids are thankfully quite easy to locate. They're present on the main asteroid belt and have a stable orbit between Mars and Jupiter. Shout out to Jupiter and his gravitational pull, by the way. Absolute chat. But just beyond the main asteroid belt are the asteroids that have crept in closer to the Earth. These are called near-Earth objects and are of particular interest to astronomers and scientists across the globe, as due to this proximity, they pose a threat to us and they need to be monitored. But one of the more prominent challenges of finding an asteroid is the fact that they reflect so little light that we can barely see them through our telescopes. And this is the reason why almost 80 to 85% of all the asteroids that have ever been detected have been detected almost directly opposite to the Sun, where it gets the light directly from the Sun. So now the question is, what happens when an asteroid lurks in the darkness of the Sun? Well, in 2013, we had an answer for it.
A meteor came crashing down to Earth today, triggered a fireball over Russia, and sent people running for cover.
On February of 2013, an asteroid entered the Russian skies of Chelyabinsk. It was about 20 meters in size, or about two school buses, and at about 30 kilometers above the ground, it exploded. At first, what seemed like a spectacle soon turned into disaster, as the shockwaves from the explosion caused a lot of damage. A very embarrassing fact about this incident was that the scientific community had already predicted that an asteroid was supposed to come astonishingly close to the Earth.
A big asteroid is hurtling through space and it's supposed to miss us by a cosmic inch, just 17,000 miles.
But that was almost hours later after this Russian incident. This asteroid, which came from the direction of the Sun, was never detected by the scientific community. Now, asteroids like these can be potentially very dangerous, but thankfully they are very rare. And we have historical stats for it. Every day, thousands and thousands of space matter enters the Earth's atmosphere. Nearly every year, an asteroid the size of a car enters the atmosphere as well, but the atmosphere is capable enough to take care of it by itself. Every 2000 years, an asteroid the size of a cricket stadium impacts the Earth, which can potentially cause significant damage to a large portion of a city. And once every few million years does an asteroid come by, which can destroy all of Earth's civilization. Like the 10 kilometer big asteroid which hit the Earth 65 million years ago. So now that we have understood the challenges and potential frequencies of these asteroids, our next step is to analyze how we predict their trajectories and subsequently whether or not they're going to impact the Earth. Like I briefly mentioned before, the way you look for an asteroid is through ground telescopes. You figure out an object of interest and then follow that object of interest through the telescopes, subsequently taking images of its path. Now, after locating it and try and figure out what bodies it's around, you try and do very simple calculations regarding gravitation and figure out what the trajectory might be eventually. And like with most calculations, the more data you have, the more observation points that you have, the more accurate your prediction would be. Now, to demonstrate this, we can go back to our old nemesis, the asteroid 2024 ON from earlier. I want to show you this very cool website. It's called the Virtual Telescope Project, and it's a remotely controlled telescope that you can watch online. So they're using this software called the Sky, which takes the telescope and captures images through it. Now, if you observe this particular spot, this very bright dot over here, And when I skim through the timeline now, so we can clearly see a trajectory of the movement of this asteroid. So now that we have visually located this asteroid, the time now comes to map this trajectory,
which would look something like this.
So if I zoom in, you can see how close the asteroid is to the Earth. That is not that far away. This is all predictive modeling, by the way. Now, this is another great way of visualizing all the asteroids that we have observed until now. This whole area between Jupiter and Mars is what makes the main asteroid belt. Now, if you just move in a little bit from this main asteroid belt, you will see one of the most infamous asteroids of recent times. Apophis.
NASA has issued an alert for a stadium-sized asteroid set to make a close approach to Earth.
Apophis, named after the Egyptian god of destruction and chaos, was an asteroid discovered in 2004. After a few measurements, it was predicted that this asteroid would hit the Earth in 2029-2036, and here's the big problem with that. Apophis is a huge asteroid, nearly 400 meters in size, and any impact, whether on ground or on water, will prove catastrophic for a big proportion of the population. If it impacts the land, it can potentially release 2,000 megatons of energy, or nearly 133,000 Hiroshima bombs. This is enough to wipe out an entire continent. And if it impacts the water, let's say the Atlantic Ocean, it can cause tsunamis so high that nearly hundreds of thousands of people will be immediately wiped out. But the impact of this asteroid will not just end there. The climate change that will come into effect because of this impact will probably lead to a death of millions, if not billions of people. Now, I'm not saying all of this just to ring alarm bells in your head. The reason I'm saying this is because no asteroid in the history of the Earth as big as this will be passing as close to Earth as this will be on April 13th, 2029. Now, here's the thing. I have to come clean. As of 2021, NASA has declared that this asteroid will not be impacting Earth in either 2029 or 2036. In fact, if you'd like to see it for yourself, NASA has a database of all potentially hazardous asteroids, and it's called Sentry. You can see a list of all the potentially hazardous objects and how close or far away they are from the Earth, but there's a little section over there called Removed Objects, wherein you can find our old friend Apophis by its official name, 9942. But then again, here's another piece of housekeeping. Although we are completely sure that there's going to be no impact of this asteroid in 2029, even a little deviation of this asteroid from its path can be extremely fatal. Now, what can cause this little deviation, you say? Well, it can be anything. It can be the fact that it collides with another asteroid, which we haven't discovered yet. Or the gravitational pull of other mass objects in the space deviates it from its path. Now, we do have mechanisms for defense against asteroids. That is something that I would like to cover in a separate video by itself. But experts do agree on the limitations of it as well. Look, I would like to emphasize this again. Astronomers and scientists have predicted very firmly that there's going to be no asteroid impact for the next century. But, and this is a big but, the universe is vastly unknown. And if the incident in Russia in 2013 is of any significant precedent, you can never really completely know what is going to hit you until it does. And while it might seem that I have projected that we are very helpless against space objects, which we probably are, I would still like to emphasize that the best that we can do right now is observe, predict, and defend. Advancements in technology are taking place. We are seeing more asteroids than ever before. And hopefully we can get to a point where we have a defense mechanism against anything that is hauling towards us. Hey guys, I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please do share and like this with other people as well. When you like a video from a small creator like us, it goes a long way in telling the YouTube gods that this video is probably worth sharing with other people as well. And currently, my biggest struggle is the fact that I don't have enough people to care about my content. So if you did, please do let us know, and also the YouTube gods. But in any case, if you like interstellar and space content like this, I have another video coming up very, very soon. Hopefully, it's something that you will watch as well. Thank you so much again, and I'll see you in a few days.